What you're going to see here is an intermixing of two different videos, one taken on a day when water levels were a foot and 2 inches higher than normal, and then 3 days later when the water had dropped 8 inches. Here's the before, and then 3 days later. Here's another before and the after. Something you'll probably notice, a difference between the before and after, is a lot of branches cleared out, clipped away, so it's easier to make passage through. Also some clearing of branches that were floating in the water and jamming up. It's now easier to get through. And certainly the water is calmer as well. Here's one of the spots that's significantly different when the water level is higher. You can pass to the left of that fallen tree. When the water is lower, you can do limbo. Water was rushing pretty strong, driving me into branches on the one day. Not a problem the next day. Though, some underwater hazards are now a little more visible, things to dodge. But at least it's at slow-mo. Big difference. On the day it was quite high, there were some large limbs, big log, bunch of stuff jammed here, and I had to plow my way through, or at least try to plow my way through. The water level was so high that once I got through this mess of branches and obstructions, it was an easy matter to float over these submerged logs. Well, they weren't submerged 3 days later. So right now, it's easy to get across, but then I was running into the the logs on the far side. 3 days later, with those obstructions gone, it was easy to make this passage, but then totally get stuck at what is no longer submerged logs. I did have to climb out of my kayak, stand in some fairly deep water, lift my kayak over these logs. It was rather a pain. And back to the rainy day, this is a view from downstream of my friend squeezing underneath the log. Much easier. 3 days later, easy to pass underneath. Okay, now the final stretch on the rainy day. Quite tumultuous, quite muddy waters, heading toward the rocks. We got to pass over the rocks. A lot calmer 3 days later. For now, I'm just comparing the rainy day and 3 days later in the section that's approaching the rocks. Certainly felt far more like a thrill when it was the much higher water. Yeah, how about the rocks themselves? Far more covered on the deeper day. More of a thrill there riding that. 3 days later, I had to know which path I needed to take. Starting on the right, swing over to the left, and then straighten out. The rest is just comparison of same sections before and after. So, what are the two main obstacles on the way in? On the way up, you encounter this bed of rocks. You got to portage that regardless. Plan to get wet up to your thighs. Maybe you'll get lucky and only up to your calves. And then there's the big logs on the way. If those are impassable, that one's a tougher one to climb out, straddle some logs, etc. Probably going to get your shorts wet. So what did you think? Is that something you'd do with me? I think it's safe. I think it's fun. Who else wants to do that?